Do you need to embed videos on your website and you don't want to look unprofessional by embedding YouTube videos? Well, there's a service that's called Gumlet that's gonna take care of this for you. They'll take care of hosting, transcoding, delivering different quality video depending on internet speed from your viewers, and much more. Let me show you what I'm talking about right now. Let me start off with the first doubt you might have. You're gonna say to yourself, why don't I just upload a video on my website? And that's the first thing you don't want to do. Why? Because it's gonna load from your hosting provider. It's gonna deduct from your CPU usage, your RAM, and it's gonna cause your site to go down when a lot of people go and watch your video on your website. Using Gumlet won't cause that because it's gonna load from Gumlet's side. Now, there's a lot of reasons why you don't want to upload it on your website or your hosting provider. So let's get started. Now, like I said, it's a video player. Plus, it also helps you with your images. So if you have a website, you can load images from Gumlet, and they also have geo distribution. So that means it's gonna load faster if they're watching it on US, Mexico, China, Australia, etc. It's gonna load closer to the server that's nearest to them. So it helps you to load those videos faster. Now, right now, Gumlet has a lifetime deal going on, which you won't wanna miss out on it. It starts off at $49 for the lifetime deal. So I mean, can't get better than that. Now, let me show you what that is going to get you. So let me jump into the deal terms and let me show you the most important parts. For example, you get obviously lifetime access, you get tied to the video growth plan updates, and you get all these features included. So unlimited video views, no limits on that, unlimited total videos, unlimited video and audio upload size, customizable player, video analytics, video CMS, multiple subtitle soundtracks, unlimited video uploads and stream API, access to S3, Wasabi, G Drive, Source. So all of that included. And these are the licensing plans that are available. So for example, it starts off at $49 for the lifetime deal, and you get access to 1,000 minutes of storage total, 500 gigabytes of streaming bandwidth per month, one user, two video collection channels, and full HD video resolution. Now, if license tier one is not enough, you can jump into license tier two, which is $99, and obviously the limits increase, and you can jump into license tier three, four, and so on and so forth with better limits. Now, on license tier three, things change a bit more. For example, you get unlimited users and you get unlimited dynamic watermark on license tier three and above. Now, if you need more limits, again, jump into license tier that is higher. Now, let me show you the player. Now, the player, this is an example right here where we have our own playhead with our own branding and colors. So it's pretty cool. For example, all muted.
Sitting duck for content theft.
I can pause it, I can change it. I have settings for the player. For example, if the quality, I don't want it auto, I could change it to one of the qualities that I designated for the video. So in this case, it's practically all, most of them are available here. There's also the settings for the speed. So you can change speed here. And these colors are customizable. If I don't want purple because purple doesn't go with my branding, I can go ahead and change it. And I can also add my logo or watermark on the video. So let's jump over to the dashboard. On my dashboard, I'm able to view everything that's going on with my video, including the stream usage, how many views, and a lot of more things. So for example, the stream usage, transcoding usage, your video insights, total views, play time, your images. I also have loaded this on a website, which I'll show you in a bit. Now to get started with videos, it's extremely easy, okay? It's not hard at all. And I'm going to show you how to actually embed a video on a website. So inside of video CMS is where we're going to have all the videos that we've uploaded. Now, before you get started, I recommend that you create a profile. For example, this one, SaaS Bits, I created, because in this profile, it's gonna be based the video that you upload, and you can create different profiles. So in this one, I called it SaaS Bits. And for this type of profile, when I upload a video, it's gonna upload with this output format, and it's gonna deliver all these type of qualities. And these qualities are really interesting because that means that the video is transcoded into these different type of qualities. That means that if I have a slow internet speed, well, it's gonna load at 360p. And I can go ahead and enable 240p, but you might say, you know what, that's, I don't know, that's, the quality is too bad, so I don't wanna allow that. Or maybe I don't want to provide 1440p. I can disable that. So it's gonna create a video for each one of these. Now imagine that, uploading on your website each quality for each video. It'll take you a lot of time, and like I said, it's gonna cost server load. Then you can generate MP4 version. You have video codecs that you want to enable. DRM, if you want to enable DRM. If you want to enable timing options, so start offset and duration. That's pretty useful when you have a certain type of videos that you don't, that you always have an intro and you wanna skip it, this is a good option. The crop options, overlay and padding, all these options available, and generate subtitles. So once you create this, you can have that option when you upload a video. So in this case, we're going back to video CMS. I'll proceed and upload a new video. I can select from the video profile I just created. So I go ahead and select this, and I have all the settings available how I want them. Like I said, you can create more profiles if you like, or you can proceed with video specific parameters. That means that this specific video that I'm going to upload, I need it with some specific parameters. But in this case, I'll keep it as my profile. Go next. I can browse through my files. I'll just grab this one for testing purposes. You can upload multiple files at the same time. I'll go click upload, and it's gonna start the upload process. I can add a title to this, a description, and some tags so I can locate it later. So I can say vid, and this is about Big Boo, and etc. Right? I'm gonna skip it for now. I'm not gonna wait for that. And once you have these videos ready, you're gonna view them just like this, okay? So you have options for this. You can go ahead and copy this shared URL, and you can go into someone, just share that link because you need to share that video, and you're gonna view it just like this. Okay, here we go, and they can just go ahead and play it. Here's my watermark on this video because I have it on my collections. So just like that. Now, what if I want to embed this? I can copy the embed code, or I can copy the playback URL. But in this case, I'm going to view details to show you everything that you can do with this video. So inside of this section, again, we have all the options to shareable, playback, or thumbnail. Copy the embed code. We can add chapters to this. So if you have a tutorial video, like for example, the one I'm making right now, I can add chapters to this. So I can add a chapter for 0 seconds for intro, 35 seconds for starting, how to talk about whatever. And you can add just like that, chapters. Super easy, okay? You can password protect it, you can call to action, you have asset details right here. You got the status events, you can view what's happening here. The video resolutions, the tags, etc., the track right here, total storage. Check this out. Like I mentioned before, it's gonna be uploaded in different resolutions. See these? Each one of these is the video that they uploaded and they took care of this. So that means that if someone wants to play it and they click the options and they select, I don't know, 360p, well, the video's there and it's gonna render it for them. The audio options, again, different type of quality options, the playlist, the thumbnail, and so on and so forth. You can change the thumbnail here if you like. Change thumbnail and you can upload one, or you can select one from the video, okay? So a lot of options. Let's start off with embedding this video just to show you how easy it is. Because like I said, if you have a website and you want to embed a video, you want it to be with your own branding and not use like something like YouTube. So copy the embed code. I'm gonna go into a website. And in this case, I'm using Divi on this side and it's on WordPress, but it doesn't matter. If you have a website, you can go ahead and embed it. I'll edit with Divi in this really quick one. And I'll select this right here. So I'm gonna get rid of this section. I'm gonna select it here. And for them, it's called code. For most, it would be called HTML. Go ahead and select it, click play, and here's the video. Obviously, I have my settings here on my builder, so I can add some padding, kind of center it, put it wherever I want. But just like that, I have a video that's not branded on my website. So in this case, I have my own brand, my own player color. I'll show you that in a bit. And that's how easy it is. So let me go ahead and show you. So we created a profile. There's also the collection options. In the collection options, I created this one. Let me go ahead and edit it, and you can create more if you like. So in this case, my collection name, the origin type, the default video profile. So it's gonna be for these right here. So I have another profile, I can tie it to that one. The default inside property, it's this one. And there's the player settings. We can preload, so it's faster for them. Autoplay, it's gonna depend on, this. It could be annoying, but it depends on your use case. Include SEO, the player color. In this case, I've selected blue because that's my color for branding. Dynamic watermark, disable seek bar. Yeah, disable player controls if you don't want to allow them to skip, jump a certain piece of the video. Bass tag if you're going to do some ads. Logo URL, that's the one that's you saw right now in the corner. The logo position, the logo width, and the logo height. And just like that, you can create a collection for this. The channel settings. Video protection if you want to enable that, and you have all these options available, okay? Now, like I said, it's really flexible. Those are things that you're not gonna have if you embed a YouTube video. I mean, sure, it's free, but it looks unprofessional, and this is much better. So let's go ahead. Next thing you wanna check out is the imported videos. If you wanna use Vimeo, you can import them from there. The usage analytics, so again, kind of like the dashboard, same thing, you can view everything that's going on, but for video specific. On the other one, we also view the images. There's also the reports. You can create reports here. I already created some and it's really flexible. So for example, I have reports for insights and I've added views. Here it's gonna show me the views. Here we go. The views, there's more reports. I actually created another one, properties. View the insights for this property. There we go. And if I wanna create one, I just go ahead and go into the reports, add a new report, and you're gonna see how flexible it actually is. You have all these options, transcoding minutes, streaming minutes, storage, the frequency you wanna get this report, the email if you wanna send it out. You can create alerts for this also. If you're going beyond the bandwidth that you have on your plan, you can set an alert just to kind of, maybe you wanna lower the qualities that you deliver to reduce that bandwidth, just a lot of options. The video insights, like we saw right now. And then we have the images. Images are pretty cool because again, they load from Gumlet's site and not on your website. Let me show you a situation. So I've added it to my test site right here and I've connected it to my WordPress site. Now that's super easy. Now, once I do that, I've had the plugin connected it together. And this is a GT metrics test that I've done. And you can see that it's loading from the Gumlet website, not from my hosting provider. And that was done really easily. So let me go into the sources, create a new source. You have all these options available. So basically everything. You have WordPress, Magento, web folder, if it's a PHP site, for example, cloud storage, Cloudinary, and Imgix. So it's super easy once you install the plugin, or in these cases, you set it up like that. And in images, you have purge cache, if you wanna do that. View the analytics for images. Here we go, here's the analytics for the images that I have on this demo site. And setting all this up for the images, it's super easy. Like I said, when you're using WordPress, you install a plugin, you set it up by adding the Gumlet source, current image domain, you can add lazy load image, that depends. Don't use it if you're using like a cache plugin, for example. Auto compress images, image quality, advanced options, and just like that, it's super easy to use. So if you're looking for a system for your videos and images, Gumlet is a great option to use. So check it out. There's a deal going on. You want to check out that link in case you want to grab it. And that's a wrap.